Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
The Pug is a cute and cuddly little dog, but they are properly known for being a lot of dog in a small package, which speaks to the breed's affable and over-the-top personality, despite its small size. Pugs are strong-willed, but rarely aggressive and are suitable for families with children. If you are considering a pug as your next pet, here are five things you should know. Number five, if you own a pug, you have a pug. If you own two pugs, you have two pugs. And if you own three or more pugs, you have a grumble. That's right, any collection of pugs more than three is considered to be a grumble. At the time of posting this video, I am not able to confirm why exactly a group of pugs are called a grumble, but I can confirm that a group of pugs is indeed called a grumble. Number four, the pug is brachycephalic, which means the head is broad and short, resulting in the smash-faced appearance that pugs are known for. There are several issues related to this condition: restricted breathing and an inability for the dog to cool itself. Therefore, it is not great to allow your pug to overexert himself while exercising or to expose your pug to extreme heat. Number three, part of what makes a pug so cute are their wrinkled faces. These faces, and specifically the wrinkles, should be cleaned on a routine basis to prevent infection and bacterial growth. Cleaning your pug's face with a warm rag or unscented wipes in the morning, after meals, and in the evenings is a good routine for keeping your pug's wrinkles clean. Number two, pugs are not great swimmers. The breed's front-heavy build makes the task of swimming very difficult. If you own a pool or frequently have access to a pool, you're going to want to keep an eye on your pug. Generally speaking, if you're looking to mix water sports and dog ownership, the pug just isn't for you. Number one, in addition to being brachycephalic, pugs suffer from many other diseases like eye prolapse, demodectic mange, and for a small breed is one of the worst affected by hip dysplasia. Pugs are not a robust breed. If you're seriously considering a pug, please do extensive research, do a serious deep dive into all the health conditions affecting the breed so that you yourself can mitigate any experience that you will have in owning a pug. And there you have it, five things anyone considering a pug as their next pet should know.